again, I don't know that most people that go agent have some policy. So you must have recommendations that they deliver, not just a historical overview where you give a conclusion. What does it mean? Remember when you go back to your research question? Remember your purpose is that why are you writing this? Are you writing this to influence thought? Are you writing it begin discussions on an issue that passionate you? That's all I'm saying. But in any way, you should have recommendations on that topic based on what you read, but also what you found. A lot of times more read, sometimes more depending topic, more we disagree with what we actually read. But that's great also. Because it's academia, it's scholarship. Conclusions, go back to chapter 4, discussion, conclusions, data analysis. But the conclusions are based on what you found and recommendations to the first policy development organization and practical. What can we do with the action? What do I want you to do with your passion? Do I want you to cite it? Do I want you to carry to your bottom material? Do I want you to have a workshop? What do you want to do with that? You don't want to do it, you must have to do something. And therefore, based on what you conclude and recommend, give an idea of the possibility of such a thing. I'm sure you have read some people sometimes that say, hey, I want to share that with you. Does this paper make sense? We can make it. Have you ever read that? Read something. It's happening to me from time to time. You read something and everything's clear. Because maybe the purpose of that paper was for students of particular interest or areas. Maybe it wasn't for a policymaker. You don't have this. You don't know. But again, the more you write, the more interested you are, I suspect you'll be guided towards writing things, not only for academia, but actually for policy implementation, or at least